We use exercise as a first step because of how pragmatic it is, not because it's a catch-all. Now think about it this way, it's a process we see all the time. No matter what you have going on tomorrow, you have 20 minutes where you're gonna meet your coach in the gym or a training buddy and get a lift in. By the third day, you are searching for ways to recover better. End up buying some protein powder. Now, unknowingly to you, protein happens to be the most satiating macronutrient. So your next meal ends up being a little bit lighter and later than it otherwise would. Without even knowing it, you've consumed less calories today. And by the end of the week, you're starting to notice some changes in the mirror that you haven't seen in a long time. Now you're starting to feel pretty good about yourself. So you start looking for ways to get more out of this routine, right? Maybe you can unplug from your phone an hour earlier than you otherwise would. Crack open a new book. And one of the passages that you stumble on seems to unlock something profound in you. You're not sure what, but something. A few books, podcasts, and a workshop later, you decide to start your own business. Go back to school and start looking at this personal development as an intoxicating journey of possibility. Just yesterday, seemingly, you were this passive rider on 30 years of unconscious habit. Today, you're exercising, eating better, sleeping better, and living your life instead of just experiencing it. Now, this doesn't happen for everybody, but it happens enough when it's you. And this story is mine. For every one person we help experience this rising tide of habit formation, it makes everything worthwhile.